Hello friends, welcome to Smart Catalyst. Today we'll be seeing the current affairs of 19 January 2019. The articles we'll be seeing for prelims are these five. First one is about the places in news, the country of Uzbekistan. Second news is about the rural housing scheme in India and its target achieved in current fiscal year. Third article is about the recent disaster of avalanche which hit the state of Jammu Kashmir. Fourth one is about the festival of Kumbh Mela 2019. The first article we'll be seeing is about the places in news, the country of Uzbekistan. This place was in news because the head of Uzbekistan is currently attending the vibrant Gujarat summit which is going on in the state of Gujarat. Here for prelims, we have to know the geography of the country Uzbekistan. So Uzbekistan, as we can see in the map, is a Central Asian country, which means it is locked by land in all its four sides. So northern side of Uzbekistan is a country named Kazakhstan. And on east it has Kyrgyzstan and Tajikistan, and in south Afghanistan and Turkmenistan. And this country is also distinguished because it's a doubly landlocked country. So what does doubly landlocked country mean? So doubly landlocked country is a country wherein all its neighbors are also landlocked. So Uzbekistan is only one of the two countries of the whole world which is doubly landlocked. So we also have to know about some of the significant features in Uzbekistan. First one is about the Aral Sea. So Aral Sea is between Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan. When you see from 1960s to current 21st century, Aral Sea has almost shrunk up to 10% of its original volume. This is because of the increase in temperature as well as over-utilization of the waters from the Aral Sea for the cotton cultivation in Uzbekistan. So another two important lakes in the state of Uzbekistan is Sayrakamish Lake and Adikakul Lake. The capital of Uzbekistan is a place called as Tashkent, and Tashkent has very important history with respect to India. This is because in the year 1966, Tashkent Agreement was signed between India and Pakistan in the place of Tashkent. We all know about the 1965 war between India and Pakistan and the ceasefire which happened in the 1964 because of the intervention of United Nations Security Council. And after the intervention, there was a peace agreement signed between India and Pakistan, and this took place in the place called as Tashkent, which is in Uzbekistan. The second article we'll be seeing is rural housing achieves only 66% of its target. This article was taken from the paper Hindu. So this article talks about the rural housing scheme called as Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, its Gramin component. So Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Gramin component is implemented by Ministry of Rural Development. This scheme, which was started in the year 2015, it aims to achieve the target of housing for all by the year 2022. It aims to build pakka houses for BPL population as well as economically weaker population, and the beneficiaries for this Awas Yojana Gramin scheme is selected as per socio-economic caste census 2011. And this socio-economic caste census has 14 parameters based on which the beneficiaries are selected, and the parameters include education, skills, housing, employment, health and nutrition, water and sanitation, social and gender mobilization, as well as entitlement. So higher the deprivation as per this 14 parameters, the more will be the money given under this scheme. In the past year, the government has brought in some changes for this scheme. And it has increased the payout for the household from 75,000 to 1.2 lakhs. As well as it has also increased the area per home from 22 square kilometers to 25 square kilometers. There's also convergence with various other central as well as state schemes under Awas Yojana Gramin. For example, toilets are built in the constructed houses in convergence with Swachh Bharat Yojana. And there is also convergence with Mahatma Gandhi Rural Employment Guarantee Act as well. However, the problem currently is only 66% of the targets set under the Awas Yojana Gramin scheme is completed till now. And the even more alarming thing is the landless, that is the below poverty line people who do not possess land on which the house is to be constructed under PMAY, they are affected the most. The states which are very back in achieving the targets include well-developed states like Maharashtra, as well as developing states like Bihar and Assam as well. The next article we'll be seeing is Avalanche Hits Ladakh's Kardung La Pass. This article was taken from the paper Indian Express. So here for the prelims, we have to know about the disaster of Avalanche. And we also have to know about the Kardung La Pass, which is situated in the state of Jammu and Kashmir near Ladakh. So what is avalanche? Avalanche is nothing but rapid downward slope movement of large masses of snow or ice or other debris, which may include rocks or even vegetation like plants from mountains in hilly areas. So this is very much common in Himalayas because it is covered with snow all throughout the year. So what causes avalanche? We all know a mountainous area is covered with heavy snow cover, and when this snow cover is weakened due to a trigger event such as earthquake or heavy rainfall or even man-made factors such as trekking or even climate change can weaken the forces of the snow cover. So on this instance, the force of gravity, it exceeds the mechanical strength of the snow cover. So then the avalanche happens. And steep slopes, which are called as convex slopes, they are more susceptible to avalanche than the concave slopes. So the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, it has recently put forward a warning with respect to the incidences of avalanche. According to the warning given by IPCC, the warming of mountains, which is basically due to the climate change, can cause more number of avalanche throughout the world. And according to the report, in the year 2019, the climate change impacts will have more avalanches and it will have more impact on the mountain communities. However, this avalanche can be predicted earlier. Due to various technological improvements and satellite technologies, remote sensing technology and satellite imagery can be used to detect the occurrence of disasters like avalanche, and mitigation steps can be taken. National Disaster Management Authority and the National Disaster Management Plan of India also has specific guidelines with respect to avalanche. The fourth article we'll be seeing is Kumbh Mela 2019. So this article was taken from the paper Hindu. So Kumbh Mela for the year 2019, it is happening in a place called as Prayag. So we have to know about the background of Kumbh Mela for the prelims exam. So Kumbh Mela is held in once in 12 years and it is held in 4 places. So since it is held in 4 places, the event of Kumbh Mela occurs once in every 3 years in cycle. So the cycle of this Kumbh Mela is decided based on the astrological positions of Sun, Moon and the Jupiter. So what are the 4 places in which Kumbh Mela is conducted? Currently it is conducted in Allahabad under the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and the mythological river of Saraswati. The second place which will be conducted is Haridwar in the banks of river Yamuna. Third place is Ujjain under the banks of river Shipra. And fourth place is Nasik under the banks of river Godavari. So this Kumbh Mela is also considered to be world's largest congregation of people, that is pilgrims on earth. And it is represented by set of rituals related to worship as well as cleansing of the holy rivers in the country of India. And another important fact which we have to remember with respect to prelims point of view is Kumbh Mela has been given Intangible Cultural Heritage Site according to UNESCO. So this was awarded in the year 2017. And it was awarded in 12th session of UNESCO, which happened in a place called as Jeju in South Korea. So with the inclusion of Kumbh Mela, there are totally 13 Intangible Cultural Heritage Sites in our country. And these include the tradition of Vedic chanting, Ram Leela, Kuttiyattam, which is a Sanskrit theatre, Raman, which is a religious and ritual theatre in the Himalayas. Mudiyattu, which is a ritual theatre and drama form in Kerala. Chow dance. Yoga, which was recently included in the year 2016. And also Parsi's New Year of Nowruz.